Ja? Mimi. When Mimi's head of brand communication cancelled 2 days before the interview, I feared that already by week 3, my plan to do one interview a week for 20 uninterrupted weeks was going to go awry. It took me a lot of convincing to arrange an interview with Gert Hildebrand, head of design at Mini instead. I spoke with him under the watchful eye of a BMW. Kut.
What?
Mini. When Mini's head of brand communication cancelled 2 days before the interview, I feared that already by week 3, my plan to do one interview a week for 20 uninterrupted weeks was going to go awry. It took me a lot of convincing to arrange an interview with Gert Hildebrand, head of design at Mini instead. I spoke with him under the watchful eye of a BMW Group PR lady in the highly secure, no pictures please, design department in an industrial zone just outside of Munich. Koenigsegg. In 2003, just as the production process has been completed, a weekend fire caused by a short circuit burned down the building. When I got there, I saw that a number of employees who lived nearby, who had seen the smoke and dragged out 2/3 of the inventory. Luckily, by sheer coincidence, my wife had taken home a backup tape of the server a few months earlier. All the drawings had been saved. The timing of the fire was terrible. We were only just up and running. But it also shows that Koenigsegg is hard to stop. A few weeks after the fire, we resumed production in 2 former jet fighter hangars, albeit at a shower pace. The hangars, which were on the grounds of an old army base, turned out to be the perfect location. Good. Bang & Olufsen. In 1925, university friends Peter Bang and Sven Olufsen started their own company, Bang & Olufsen, in Sven's parents' house. This was a time in which more and more households were becoming connected to the electric grid. The friends developed one of the first radios that worked on electricity. They also developed a sound recording system for the film industry and loudspeakers for army vehicles and the circus. The two formed a magic pair. Peter was the brain behind the technology and Sven was responsible for the commercial activities of the companies.
Is finished?
Yeah, finished. Thank you.
Yeah.
Victorinox. After the Second World War, American soldiers en masse sent the Swiss Army knife home as a souvenir, even though the name proved to be something of a tongue twister. They spontaneously renamed Victorinox Swiss Army, a name that rolled off the tongue easily. As of that moment, we received orders from across the world. The knife became an icon for Switzerland, and together with their Swiss competitor Wenger, they claimed the exclusive right to use the name Swiss Army. Both Victorinox and Swiss Army became very well known. For years, the company could barely handle demand. Only when they partly computerized the factory in 1992 did its production capacity increase. As a consequence, supply exceeded demand. Victorinox set up a marketing department and started advertising for the first time. Dag Dukkie.